Big guys, for the forward roll, going to load her weight up on her toes, arms are out in front of her, locked out. Okay, her knees are gonna line up directly behind her arms. As her weight shifts forward onto her arms, she'll then pull her arms into herself as she tucks her chin. So you'll see the roll start to happen before she actually even hits the ground. You can roll right through the movement, okay? In order to really prevent that disorientation from happening, we're actually gonna have these guys stand up in between reps. Full extension. Go ahead and walk up, stand. Good, nice small steps as he goes up. Walk his chest all the way to the deck. Excuse me, all the way to the wall. Good, and then he's gonna walk down. He's not gonna take big steps on the way down. He's gonna keep his body in a nice plank position. He walks down. Again, chest all the way to the floor. One of the things you wanna focus on most, in addition to obviously keeping that core really, really tight, is the position of your hands, okay? So Stan, go ahead and walk up just partially for me and pause. So as Stan walks up right here, notice that his hands are underneath his shoulders, and he's gonna keep his hands under his shoulders and close to the wall, not out ahead of him, causing too much excess fatigue on the shoulder. Four toes to bar, Kevin's gonna jump up, grabbing the bar, and his body's in full extension. Okay. You have two ways to go through this. You can obviously do it strict, one movement at a time. So Kev, let's show us one. Kev, sorry, up. Any part of his toes or shin touches the bar, he comes back down to full extension. His feet pass through the plane of the bar to the bottom. You also can kip this movement today. If you do that, you want to make sure in between reps, full extension of the shoulder, full extension of the hip, and the toes again pass through the plane of the bar to the bottom. Yeah, guys, so the standards today for the box jumps, gentlemen are jumping on 30 inches, okay? When you get to the top of the box, you open your hips all the way, lock the knees out, and go full rest and pop under control.
Really tuck that head, keep your core braced, and really look forward. Find that spot on the wall, so you're coming out of it and you know where to go for the next one, just to avoid dizziness.
The worst part was definitely the wall walk. I just tried to keep at a steady pace. I knew I wasn't gonna be able to do them straight. So I would do one, and at the bottom I would just unload, take three deep breaths, and go back up again, and try to just stay with that pace. I knew if I just didn't give myself a set amount of time, be it through breaths or seconds, I would just stay there forever, so.
Your WODs are really important because they're just the right amount of suck, just the right amount of pain to remind you like what you're doing them for and who you're remembering.